Okay, hello and a warm welcome to all. Welcome to Research Circle. I hope I am audible to all. So welcome for today's webinar. And we are going to conduct a webinar on the topic identification of groundwater potential zone mapping using GIS and remote sensing in the case of Yeda watershed, Abyss Basin, Ethiopia. And for this, we have with us our today's expert, Vasi Dasin Kedi. Is an civil and water resource engineering lecturer and instruct students who have obtained an upper secondary education diploma in their own specialized field of study, engineering, which is predominantly academic in nature. He worked with their university research assistants and university teaching assistants for the preparation of lectures and of the exam, for leading laboratory practices, granting papers and exams, and for leading reviews and feedback sessions for the students. He also conducts academic research in my field of civil and research, civil and water resource engineering, and published the findings and less with the other university colleagues. So without wasting further time, let me introduce Mr. Vasi Dasin Kedi. Please continue, sir.
Okay, can you hear me?
Hello, yes, guys. Sir.
Okay, sorry, the participant is very, I hope the participant is seven, I see in seven participants. So, can you wait in a minute or let's proceed? Hello.
Yes, sir. Please proceed.
Is that? Okay.
Yes,
sir. Okay. As you, first of all, I'm grateful. I'm excited to present my original work, Identification of Groundwater Potential Zone Area Mapping using Remote Sensing and GIS Techniques, the case of Yeda Watershed in Abyss Basin, Ethiopia. You all are now, where is Abyss Basin? Blue Nile. This is the tributary of the Nile River or Abyss Basin in Ethiopia, presented by me. I'm Vasi Dasin Kedi. I have a MSc Master of Science degree in Hydraulic Engineering, and my basis is in Civil Engineering. For the time being, I'm lecturer of Civil and Water Resource Engineering at Debre Marcos University, Institute of Technology, School of Civil and Water Resource Engineering. So when it comes to presentation, there is a presentation outline. There is introduction part, there is assessment of problem, and objectives, scope of the study, literature review, methods and data use, data discrimination, methods, results and discussion, conclusion and recommendation. Finally, there is a reference part. As you know, an introduction or background of my study, groundwater is one of the super interested natural resources which supports human healthiness, economic development and environmental diversity. Because of its enormous innate qualities, it has become an immensely significant and trustworthy source of water supply in all climatic regions, including both municipal and pasturized areas of developed and developing countries. As Todd and Mays in 2005 said, groundwater characterization, the next greatest supply of living freshwater resource, and constitutes about 30% of fresh water, water resource of the world groundwater, as Sabarmalia 2008 said. More than 1.5 billion people in the world are known to be contingent on the groundwater for their drinking water supplies. Groundwater has been a common source of water in several countries. As you know, geographical information system or GIS is or remote and remote sensing is the optional method in this 21st century to provide all parameters which influence groundwater potential zone of one area, and it can access manipulate and analyze the spatial and temporal data from satellite image. Besides to this, Gupta and Sarvastivada in 2010 explained several decision analysis approaches such as multi-criterial decision making or analytical hierarchy process, such like that three logic to fill the gap of water scarcity and decision making on groundwater potential zone mapping. You know, analytical hierarchy process is useful method for complex decision making. A series pairwise comparison matrix is for checking the constancy ratio, and that the decision makers use this type of the statement of problem or the cause of to study this idea of this development of as my statement of problem. As you know, groundwater assessment in Ethiopia is mostly conducted by field survey, most of the time, not only Ethiopia, in the world, mostly conducted by field survey, which is tedious and it's handled in terms of time and resource. In the present study area, the number of population increased from time to time in Abay Basin, in Yeda Waterfield, around Ethiopia, Yeda Abay Basin, the Blue Nile Basin, and East Gojam Zone in Ethiopia, around Amhara region. In the population increase from time, most of the time water drinking and irrigation from the Yeda River and its tributaries. There is a limitation of information gaps related to groundwater potential zones identification. Hence, the present study fails to gap by applying GIS and remote sensing techniques to identify and map the groundwater potential zone. However, very limited studies are available in Ethiopia context in general and the Yeda watershed in particular. Therefore, the aim of this study is to employ rain or sensing and GIS techniques in order to identify and map the groundwater potential zone. The general objective of this study, the main objective of this research is to identify groundwater potential zones in Yeda watershed by using remote sensing and GIS-based analytical hierarchy process. And specific objectives, there are three specific objectives. The first one, to identify factors that affect groundwater potential zone and prepare thematic map. The second specific objective, to identify and delineate groundwater potential zone through integration of various thematic layers with geographical information system and remote sensing techniques. And the final specific objective of this study is to prioritize groundwater potential zones and identify controlling parameters, area of using pairwise estimation software for further exploration. There is research questions or to answer the final result. These three research questions that are: what are features which affect groundwater potential zone identification, where is the groundwater potential is available, and which one is are the dominant factor among the groundwater occurrence controlling parameters. The significance of this study to result of the study of groundwater potential zone may provide information about the productive well location and the study area. This could reduce the extra labor and time required in setting well location for the groundwater exploration. Provision of such maps may provide good information for well analysts and decision makers. That to produce and structured groundwater potential map may also be your database, which will permit decision makers, the liable stakeholders, and the appropriate and used and cooperative resource in this study area. The scope of the study, in this study, groundwater potential is defined as the possibility of groundwater occurrence in the area. Therefore, an attempt was made to identify and map the possibility of groundwater occurrence through assessing and analyzing groundwater occurrence controlling parameters like that of rainfall, rock geology, geomorphology, soil, and so on. Using integrated GIS and remote sensing techniques, this study includes only identifying the possibility of groundwater occurrence qualitative terms in either watershed. As you know, different literatures are say about groundwater potential. and the groundwater occurrence. The groundwater is used to cope the heat or endless levels of after 1950 in many parts of the world in the demonstration of fuel and machine driving pumping design in the right on time during century. And they're making a claim was seen after 1950. In Spain, groundwater is right from 2 cubic kilometers for each annum to 6 in excess to, as you know, in India subcontinent, groundwater is raised from around 10 up to 20 cubic kilometers for each per year, as you shown. In the United States, the groundwater of forest reserves and Chinese ancient times achieved an intentional phase of rancher. Groundwater is a vital resource, as you know, water supply for the inordinate majority of the population. And the main source of groundwater in the country are spring hand dug wells and drilled boreholes piloted on groundwater availability and used in sub-Saharan Africa country. Review of 15 countries. He summarized Pavlik and his friends summarized that the hydrologic condition of sub-Saharan Africa are the major controller of underground water more than water country. And category the hydrological aquifer parameter of sub-Saharan into crystal-like basement, multifaceted rocks, consolidated sedimentary rock, unconsolidated sedimentary rock, and volcanic rocks. And HSS work accompanied by Bane in 2017 in Middle Awash River Basin in Ethiopia, demarcated, categorized groundwater potential and recharge zones, utilized 9 filters. Thus were rainfall, slope, geomorphology, geology, land density, and drainage density, surface runoff, and land use, land cover, and soil textures. Similarly, CSI 2007 was applied similar approach to generate thematic maps such as geology, geomorphology, land maintenance, soil rainfall, and land use, land cover maps, slope and drainage for producing groundwater potential map of northern Ada Plain, Mojo catchment in Ethiopia. The groundwater potential zones was gathered while we tested with borehole data, but the mainly control factor of the occurrence of groundwater such as geology, geomorphology, and lineament was produced from satellite image without verified with Ethiopian geology survey. When it comes to methods and data use, description of the study area, Yeda watershed is found in Amhara region, upper Blue Nile basin, which is dominated by highlands. Yeda is also located northern west of Ethiopia. Capital Addis Ababa, approximately at the distance of 300 kilometers. Yeda watershed is located in northwestern highland of Sosa, within 10 degree 40 minutes northing to 10 degree 30 minutes northing and 37 degree 48 easting to 37 degree 54 degree minutes, sorry, easting with the total area of coverage 125 kilometers square. As you shown the figure from Ethiopia map, from Amhara, from the East Gojam zone, Yeda watershed is clearly stipulated as you shout around this. Data description software and methods. ArcGIS model uses prominently both temporal and spatial data. The input data used in the study included our spatial data, which involves digital elevation model, study area delineation and definition of streams. Secondary data, which were modified into the two lithology, rainfall, and soil map of the area. Digital elevation model data. This digital elevation model will describe topography of the area. A digital elevation model of Yeda River watershed at a resolution of 1 arc second, 30 meter by 30 meter, using path and draw of 169.53 respectively, was retrieved. To prepare the elevation, slope, drainage, density, and geomorphological map, either shuttle radar topographic mapper or ASTER digital elevation model centimeter data could be used. In this study, shuttle radar topographic mapper digital elevation model 30 meter was selected since it's more accurate both in its vertical and horizontal accuracy than ASTER DM. Or as the digital elevation model. The other is rainfall data. Rainfall plays an important role in the hydrologic cycle and controls groundwater potential. Knowing the nature and characteristics of precipitation, it can be conceptualized and predicted its effect in runoff, infiltration, and groundwater recharge. Therefore, for hydrological analysis, it's important. And Yeda watershed rainfall extracted from Abebe's rainfall station acquired from National Meteorology Agency, since the rainfall gauges and measured point data should be converted to aerial rainfall using some interpolating techniques, is due to prepare the rainfall map due to an uneven distribution of the station. In the study area, data were interpolated using inverse distance weights, nearest neighboring interpolation techniques, as you shown in this figure, annual rainfall station source of National Meteorological Agency of Ethiopia. Land is land cover map data is the other. The effect of land is land cover is manifested either by reducing groundwater and facilitated by trapping water of their surface, and to produce land use land cover map of the city area, by being prepared by MRI design and supervision work enterprise, was clipped with the watershed chip profile. And the other is soil data is an important factor of delineating the groundwater potential zones. According to the World Reference Base for Soil Source, PAO, which updated on 2050, the steady area major soil tests are presented as follows. Chromatically phosphide, these soils are with pedogenotic alkali difference, especially clay migration between topsoil with lower and subsoil with higher clay content. Phyllic and chromic virtual soils, thus, are heavy clay soil with a high proportion of swelling clay. Phyllic virtual soils have the most cormos of less than 1.5 dominant of the soil matrix, so of the upper 50 meters. The other geology of the study area. It's one of the major factors which play an important role in distribution and occurrence of groundwater. The geology lithology thematic map of the study area was prepared by produced by Geologic Survey of Ethiopia and the year of 2011 and 2013 respectively, and clipping was the shape file of the Yeda watershed. And the other is drainage density. The drainage system of any area always plays an important role in various ways of their reflect the lithology and structure of a given area. Drainage density delineated using geographical information system and hydrological tools, shattered radar topographic mapper, digital elevation model data. Drainage density is measured with the total length of the stream segment of the data. The methods to conclude my work, GIS and remote sensing techniques were applied to delineate groundwater potential zone on Yeda watershed river basin. The pairwise comparison matrix was carried out by using analytical hierarchy process procedure to calculate the cumulative weight of the main criteria. The relative weight of the corresponding class was considered. Map category and weight assigned for groundwater potential zone mapping 8 parameters, land cover, alignment, slope, geomorphology, geology, soil, drainage, and rainfall are selected for groundwater potential zone mapping. The method of this research work includes the following stages: identification and evaluation criteria, data collection, pre-processing, input data set, reclassification input layers, pairwise comparison criteria, and give weight with analytical hierarchy process, overlay analyze with weight. Some overlay analysis are just to ranking of the final value. As you shown, this is the overall framework of the methodology. First of all, there is a satellite image, Landsat 8, and digital elevation model, conventional existing map, meteorology data. When from satellite image, Landsat 8, data pre-processing, layer stacked, and net difference moisture index, and from digital elevation, slope, drainage to extract those data and elevation, from conventional existing map to extract soil map and land cover, from geology map, digitize the geology map and lineament to extract lineament and lithology. From those maps to just pre-processing and building the database, to drive the map of soil stiffness, drainage density, elevation, soil map, land use cover, lithology, lineament, and rainfall. And finally, those maps are overlaid by using GIS analysis. Finally, groundwater potential map is cut. And finally, validated using net different moisture index and boreholes data. And finally, validated groundwater potential map. This is overall framework of the methodology. Finally, results and discussion. Delineation of groundwater potential zones. The present study has attempted to apply integrated remote sensing and GIS for generating new thematic data layers as well as existing data. for delineating potential groundwater zone in Eda watershed. The 8 factors which have been used for the final alliance to achieve the proposed objective. Factors controlling groundwater occurrences. Those are groundwater controlling parameter of the study area can be determined through field survey, analysis of available information, the external literature, and combined professional expert judgment. The data of rainfall, geomorphology, slope, drainage density, geology, alignment, density, land cover, and soil types were considered as the main groundwater potential controlling parameter of the present study area. When it comes to rainfall map, as you show in the figure, area and reclassified rainfall map of Yeda watershed, rainfall is the most important factor for the formation of groundwater potential. The rainfall map of the study area, as shown in this figure, the amount of rainfall is not the same for the places, and it varies based on the environmental conditions of the place. Rainfall and its rank as per suitable for groundwater potential as value in millimeter and suitability class and rank in number as usual as presented in the table. The high rainfall distribution along high slope gradient in the northern and western part of the study area, that parts directly affect the infiltration rate groundwater potential zone in the study area. The other is the important factor is soil map, slope map. Slope is one of the important terrain parameters, which is explained by the horizontal spacing of the contours. The lower slope value indicates the flatter terrain or gentle slope. The lower slope areas of the flat terrain allow rainfall infiltration and percolation, and higher slope areas correspond to steeper slope, generating Q crown from the terrain. There are 4 classes of these slopes that identified in Yeda watershed by basin, upper Brunei, and the gentle slope is 0 degree to 8.4 degree is observed when step down to the southern part of the watershed, implies the flood. A very high steep slope, as you show in the figure, slope in degree and reclassified slope map of the study area. In the gentle slope area of the surface runoff flow, allowing the more time for rainwater to percolate and high infiltration, whereas high hilly slope are very low infiltration and has very poor groundwater perspectives. The other important map is drainage density map. The drainage density ranges along. Can you hear me, guys?
Yes, sir.
Okay. The drainage density range from 0 up to 4.85 kilometers per kilometer square in this study. The drainage density are classified as very low, moderately low, and high, and very high using the natural breaks or junk classification methods in GIS environment, as you shown in the figure. The relationship of the drainage system of the area and alignments as shown in the drainage system of the area is structurally controlled the following. In this study area, dendritic and parallel drainage patterns are recognized, which are inductive of the presence of structures that act as conduits or storage for subsurface water. The other important factor is geomorphology map. For geomorphology controls, the subsurface movement of groundwater, it is one of the most important features in the evaluating groundwater potential and prospect, and that it can be utilized for management of groundwater resource. To prepare the geomorphology map, the human and landform classification techniques acquired from gis4geomorphology.com was used. As you shown the map, there is geomorphology classification in lowland, moderate hill, and plateau. And the other is geology map. Geology or lithology, that is an important groundwater controlling parameter which should be considered in groundwater studies. There are 4 major lithology types below identified in the study area, namely tertiary plateau basalts and percolastes and tertiary upper basalts and tertiates and quaternary lucestrine sediments and tertiary upper lava flows. As the name indicates, around the my study area, The first one, PVC one, this naming is Rob Gewehr Basel. This unit is exposed in the northern part of the study area. It's dated 22.4 up to 23 mean from the Toke mountain shield volcano. This unit is explored the base of the Toke mountain shield volcano. The precolastic tufa and trichite seals interlayered with Rob Gewehr Basel. The thick percolastic tufa has overlain by thin basalt layer. As you shown, the geomorphology or geological map of the study area, there is the Marcos Basal, TV3, and around the Marcos, the southern part of and northern and central part of the study area. It forms of scarpment cliffs and ridges, hills, moderate slope, and gentle slope. And the other is Lumami Basal, TV4, Lumami Basal exposed in the southern western and northwestern part of the area. The other is quaternary alluvial sediment. The alluvial sediment in the study area is developed from all rock types from the incipient alteration of the bedrock. The other lineament density map is represent fault fractures and master joints along and linear geological formation of topographical linearity. As you shown in the figure, lineament is density map of Edawates. The study are lineament feature was generated from geological map of Deborah Marcos and Lumami sheets based on digitization method using GIS and have prepared the lineament map. The lineament density of the study area was calculated using kernel density analysis tools in GIS software, and the area has been reclassified into four class. The other land is land cover is a surface covered by vegetation like forests and agriculture crops, and holds the water root of plants where is a built up area to produce this map and water hold capacity of the ground. As you shown the figure, there is grass and shrubland, forest land and cropland, and bare soil is our land cover map. The other is factor, the most important factor is soil map. Soil is an important factor of delineating the groundwater potential zone, the water holding capacity of the area depend upon the soil type and the permeability. The soil map of Ida watershed is prepared from the soil map of Ethiopia acquired from Minister of Water Resource Irrigation Energy Ministry using the geoprocessing clip tool in ArcGIS tools. As you show in soil map of Ida watershed, weight of each factor for groundwater potential, weight of rainfall for groundwater potential as you show, and weight of slope as you shown study source, weight of slope of groundwater potential, and weightage of drain density of groundwater potential. The other weightage of geology factor for groundwater potential and weightage of lineament density for groundwater potential. Weightage of land use land cover for groundwater potential as you shown, grass and shrub continent and land covers with tree vegetation cover over 30% of including deciduous and coniferous forests and spread woodland of the cover. This given weight 7 and forest land cover with the shrubs and grasses natural area. Weightage of soil factors, groundwater potential, and the soil as you show. And the finally is analytical hierarchy process. As you shown, analytical hierarchy process, it would give a meaningful result without the need of conducting field geophysical data investigation and drilling test techniques are both time, effort, and cost-consuming activities. In this present study, groundwater potential zone mapping was done by analysis of different thematic layers, rainfall, soil texture, slope, land cover, lineament, geomorphology, drainage, and geology. As you shown in this figure, this is the relative weight of four selected as used the table. Thematic layers, soil, geology, lineament, drainage, rainforest, geomorphology, and land cover. And there is they have a weight and a weight in percent. The consistency index was computed to overcome for the formula of consistency ratio. This was done based on the equation, which result consistency index 0.0370. Then the consistency ratio was computed as per the equation, and the computer result of consistency ratio 0.026, that is less than 0.1, and the given weight was valid for the further analysis. This is groundwater potential zone map was computed after taking all cut criteria as follows. To compute groundwater potential zone is shown in the figure. This is the weight times the map, and Finally, the map of groundwater potential zone, map of the Yeda watershed as shown in the figure, as very good and low. And by the integration of automatic maps, groundwater potential zone were delineated and classified as very good, moderate, or poor. Especially the high categories are distributed along areas near correspond to flat line and gentle topography are coincide, and areas with moderate groundwater prospect are attributed to contribution from combination of the land use cover, geology, slope, and the morphology and soil caps. The low to very low categories of groundwater potentials are especially distributed mainly along the ridges where slope class is very high to the geology is compact clay soil composition and far from dynamics. And this study area 31.4 kilometer square is moderate, 97.48 kilometer square is low, and 0.97 kilometer square high groundwater potential zones have been identified. As you in the figure, groundwater potential zones percentage and the area coverage, rainfall, land cover, soil and geology. Hello, can you hear me? Guys, is there any problem? I'm concluding my work. And finally, model validation. The validation of the groundwater potential zone generated using GIS and remote sensing techniques were cross-checked through the overlay method with net difference weather index and net difference moisture index and existing borehole data, which is collected from East Gojam Zone Water Resource and Development Office. Normalized difference water index, as you showed, the normalized difference water index is the area derived from USGS Landsat 18 measure image, which was developed for the extraction of open water feature of the study area. And using band 3 minus band 5 over band 3 plus band 5 equals green near infrared and green plus near infrared. And the normalized different moisture index is the other theoretical similar to each of the detection of spatial variation of surface weakness. And discuss the above, the, there is no water pixel have been identified through net different water index. Therefore, the net different moisture index was needed to check the weakness of the present in soil. The weight or the moisture pixel are given the idea about the regions where the water can resist for long term, often finishing the rainfall event because the water cannot resist a plant. Therefore, the result also showed in the moisture pixel. As you show, the net difference moisture in the high index, the high values indicate the existence of the more soil moisture under massive water bodies, and low values donate low soil moisture content. As you shown in the figure, the net difference moisture index map of the study area and groundwater potential zones related with net difference moisture index. Validated with existing boreholes, the well observed in the study area were located in the moderate and good groundwater potential flowing the same altitude. For verification of result map, secondary field data was collected from 106 observation wells, of which 14 wells are used for validation. Among the 7 wells fell in the category of low, and 7 wells are good groundwater potential zones. The value which is depth of 16.5 to 70.5 meter, and the yields of 7.065 up to 67.51 liter per second categorized low groundwater potential zones. All 7 wells which were used for validation and the 7 wells often there are found in the good groundwater potential zone. The value is the depth of 70.5 up to 80.8. Meter and yield of 68.295 up to 777.15 liter per second in good zones. This indicates the good agreement between the observed and simulated result. In addition, the most borehole data has closer relationship with the net difference moisture index result shown in the figure, groundwater potential zone related to borehole and net difference moisture index. And the final conclusion and recommendation is the application of GIS and remote sensing techniques demonstrates the best tool for the identification of groundwater potential zone. In this study, groundwater potential zone was identified and delineated by using GIS and remote sensing techniques through an analytical hierarchy process. The spatial distribution of the groundwater potential zone in the study area were assessed and mainly controlled by the force for thematic layers such as rainfall, geology, soil, and land cover. Very good. And sure, the southern part of the area was good and now in 97.47 kilometer high potential groundwater potential zone was identified to the central part of the study area. Low potential zone at the northwestern part of the study area and good for groundwater potential zone was present southern part of the study area. And the net difference water index has not shown any peaks of the water bodies. The river is also seasonal, that highly depend on rainfall. Therefore, the result clearly indicates that the area has surface water scarcity, except the rainy season. In this, it has been found in the moisture index showed the range between and negative 1 to 0. Thus, pixel of net difference moisture index shows that the water resistance and holding capacity after rainfall moisture. And therefore, integration of the ice and remote sensing technique was with analytical hierarchy process approaches demonstrate the best tool to identify the groundwater potential zone in this region for better management of groundwater resource. There is some recommendation based on finding noted in this study. The following recommendations were drawn. The result obtained from the present work is good related to time cost and accurate identification of groundwater potential zone. Therefore, more studies that, such as geological, hydrological, and water study should be done with the application of remote sensing. And GIS is highly recommended because remote sensing data has great role in to improve our understanding of groundwater system. This is all about my original work. Thank you for your attention. If you have any questions and suggestions, you're welcome. Thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you, Professor. If anyone has any questions, you are free to ask.
Hello, good evening, sir.
Hello.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening, yeah.
Sir, how do you compare with model validation, sir? By which, what are the parameters you've taken to validate the model, sir?
Okay. I can use to validate the model as you shown in the final part of my study. I can use net difference water index map and net difference moisture index map, and also plus to that borehole data from the existing study area. Existing borehole data are the parameters used for the validation of my model. Can I hear?
Yeah, it's audible.
Yeah, can I get your question and answer?
How many parameters you have taken? Only one parameter you have taken to validate model, or how many parameters you have taken, sir?
Three parameters I can take three to validate.
Which are those?
Those are net difference water index, net difference moisture index, and the existing borehole data.
Okay. Can you share this PPT along with your email ID and phone number so that I'm also working in this aspect only? So I will be working with respect to research to submit my thesis also in this domain itself. So can you share these details? Is it possible we will convey it further also?
Okay. This is my original work. And it's not published.
Okay. If it is there, it's okay. At least share your details, sir. I have shared my mail.
Yeah, I can share any literature related to this.
Please. If anything doubt will be arises, then I will get back to you, sir.
Please input your email address and I can share some data related to this work. Thank you.
Okay, thank you.
Any another? Any another question, you can welcome.
Okay, so I guess that's it for today's session, because no more questions are there. So thank you so much, Professor, for taking out the time and delivering such a nice session. And this session will be available on our Research Circle YouTube channel, so you can watch.
Okay, thank you very much. See you. Can I close my window?
Yeah, thank you so much. Have a good time.